saying, on my way to Addis, as we're about to land over, the airliner said, on behalf of every passenger on board, we are planting a tree. So I was actually looking for the connection between the amount I paid for my trip and planting of tree. And they said they are planting this tree in the flight origin, at this, I mean Ethiopia, in order to combat ozone layer depletion. On our way back, Abdul Talam Mohammed International Airport, they told us that thank you for using Ethiopian airline without the promise of planting a tree. So I said that the success of our community is a collective responsibility. Then I founded the Protect Ozone Project. Protect Ozone Project, we have key five activities. Number one, we have excursion whereby we take children, youth, and farmers from the very rural communities affected with ozone layer depletion, erosion, you know, we take them on an all-expense-paid trip to the University of Ibadan Botanical Garden, where they learned, where they are taught about how to plant a tree, and they are given the opportunity to select the seed of choice for replication in their community. By doing this, we have actually trained a lot of people on this particular excursion. Then training, we train farmers, children, and active citizens on sustainable best agricultural practices, because we notice the amount of damage that happens in our society is due to, the ozone layer depletion is due to improper farming practice, whereby they use chemicals and what have you. It rains back to our heads to destroy our community. That is training. We also have a distribution of seed and seedling. To date, we've distributed about 25,000 seeds across the country, across five states of the country and the Federal Capital Territory. Also, we have an establishment of school farms. We notice that in agrarian communities, the children of farmers are transcending from agriculture into buying of Okada, that's popularly known, so that they could make fast money. They see agriculture as being difficult and drudgery to go into. So we train them, we establish demo farms, we call it demo farms. We establish demo farms whereby we train them on sustainable best agricultural practices and giving them improved seeds. One of the mistakes our farmers made and the society has made us to make is by telling us and making the farmer plant the seeds of their produce, which is quite bad. But now we provide the children with improved seeds, they plant them and they have better produce. Today, the children are returning back to agriculture. Then we have our innovation. We innovated the mobile kitchen garden that got us the award-winning mobile kitchen garden, whereby we use, in Nigeria, we notice that paper, bottle, and metal waste materials are properly recycled, but bamboo tires are not properly recycled. We find them on our drains, inside our drains, they block the drains, causing flood. We find them on the road, we use them as sea caution when our trailer breaks down, we burn them on our road, destroying the road and the ecosystem. We systematically use this tire to combat ozone layer depletion by systematically using local content initiative to produce vegetable. So one of our children is actually using this vegetable pot to feed the family. For the past 6 months, the family has not gone to the market to buy vegetables. Personal mission statement. It is my mission to ensure a safe environment for man, not only man, but animals, through children, youth, and farmer participation in community development, upholding integrity in all, transcending this into the younger generation. Code of conduct. I am passionate, sustainable, eco-friendly farmer, enthusiastic about local content initiative. I believe that whatever is going to work in our community is resident in situ in our community. I believe nature has everything it takes to give us the best where he has positioned us. So that is why we use local content initiative. I will ensure quality and empathy in my dealings. I will create a vibrant atmosphere for less privileged to express their ideas, believing that even the fool has something to say. Please always listen to me too, you know, I can be funny at times. Key lessons. Applying thinking systems, moral ethics, organization, sustainability, communication skills. I like that. I don't like it. I lack that a lot, which I'm trying to improve myself. Leveraging on social media. Anytime I travel, I love using, you know, selfie, post anything on Facebook and stuff. So people no longer like anything I post on Facebook. I have over 5,000 friends and I will see 20 likes, 2.5 likes. But now, from now, I will post reasonable things so that I have good likes. The networking. Sincerely speaking, one of the best things that has happened to me here is networking. I will continue to refer and reference Cynthia and Cynthia. You guys are wonderful. Thank you. You know, meeting someone like Eitayo, wonderful. Having close relationships with Bruce Bailey, wonderful. Thank you so much, everybody. I used to see Choma from afar. Who is this lady? When he says, "Pass the best case ever," hey, me, really. So, very wonderful. Thank you, everyone. Let me tell you, when you talk about Protect to Zoom, one of the things I think I've done right is I was able to differentiate my farm, which is the business aspect registered as the Business Africa Integrated Farms, from Protect to Zoom project. But sincerely speaking, when you say Protect to Zoom, I'm the only one, I'm the accountant. Well, we don't have accounts. I am the worker on the farm, I'm the this and that. But sincerely speaking, I will leverage on the network I have. My volunteers, they have a distinct area where they are good at. Sincerely speaking, I'll put them together now and channel their energies right there. Organization structure, we put that to report writing. Report writing, I'll put that in place and leveraging on digital skills. Organization as far as goals. So in 2017, we are currently constructing a two-story building whereby it's called our Agri Lab. Instead of going about training children, we can bring them to Lagos State regardless of how remote our farmers are. Because we've been to a farm settlement whereby we just train persons under the tree. But currently we have a building structure of 8 classrooms. We'll be having our first decking very soon in Lagos here, though Lagos exterior, Ikorodu. So we'll be completing that by March, not March of 2017, but as God will help us. The recruiting of passionate volunteers, I think that's one of the key lessons I've taken away from here, which I'm going to do. Our board is going to be in place. In the year 2017, by September, we shall be distributing, now on our demo site, the Agri Lab at Ikorodu, we'll be raising a seedling of 2,000 fruits trees, whereby we are going to plant. And by this time next year, we are going to be flying a drone on our demo farm to capture our fruits, whereby we collect trees and distribute more to the world. In the year 2017, we plan to distribute about 50,000 tree seeds and seedlings across the country. Thank you.